You know what? I think that's the best backstory. Let's go with the Mahjong. How's it going, YouTube lovers? This is the Gibbler Amber. Welcome back to another video. Today, I'm doing another reaction video. Today, I'm reacting to another Apex Legends video. I assume this is the stories from the Outlands for the new Legend. It doesn't say it in the title, but they often change things, like, after the premiere, and I'm, like, right after the premiere on this. But it is called Based on a True Story, and is all about the new Legend, Alter. I know that this has already leaked, on Reddit a bit ago. I have been actively avoiding seen anything from this trailer because I want to react blind to it here in the video for y'all. So I'm really looking forward to seeing what this is about. Alter, like, has a really cool character design from what I have seen in the leaks. Again, I've only avoided the story leaks. The gameplay leaks and stuff, I just eat those all up. I don't care. But this is a new Stories from the Outlands, I assume, for the new Legend. And she's got, like, Void abilities, which makes me think she's gonna have some kind of connection to Wraith, but she also seems to be, like, having some kind of connection with Horizon, maybe has to do with the time travel device that Horizon's been messing with recently in the lore. So I'm excited to jump into this and see exactly what this character has to offer. I apologize if my voice seems a little weird. I am getting over a cold. You would know this if you watched my Bendy the Dark Revival stream. But let's go ahead and jump into this video and see what exactly is going on with Alter and her backstory. Okay, so we've got a nervous person right away. Ooh, that doesn't look good. Oh, well, there's Alter.
Every person in every world asks me the same
In every thing. World. So she definitely has some kind of, like, Wraith-esque thing going on here. Ooh, hello, P20.
Well, ooh. If you really want to know...
I like her voice.
For years, they raised me to be a killer. And I was the best. But when they betrayed
me, okay, then, so she is crazy.
I only had one choice. Every person in every world asks me the same thing.
Who are you?
Well, listen carefully.
For years... Oh, but just make it blatantly obvious what's going on right there.
Every person in every world asks me the same thing.
Who are you?
Well, Zaki Kingpin. For years, I was a hunter of the old.
Whoa, whoa. Okay, then. That's not a connection I was expecting.
Also, I had a bird. Every person asks me the same thing.
Who are you?
I was a dedicated martial artist, but then I discovered a passion.
So she just comes up with her own backstories constantly. So, or maybe there's, like, alternate versions of her.
I was born of stone with tremendous power, fighting to gain immortality.
Who are you?
I was the reigning Mahjong champion.
You know what? I think that's the best backstory. Let's go with the Mahjong. Wow, she just comes up with whatever she wants in this. But maybe it is an alternate reality thing. Those are all actual backstories that she's had in different realities.
Who am I? I'm the one who's there at the end.
Ooh.
Or am I?
Whoa. That's a cool shot. So, I think I see where they're going with this character's story here. Upheaval, that's the name of the season. Gameplay trailer. Gameplay trailer. Is there not going to be a launch trailer for this? Was that the launch trailer? Interesting. Well, I mean, they are pretty much out of time to release trailers, so. Again, I only react to, like, the stories from the Outlands and, like, launch trailers when it comes to Apex, so. I won't be reacting to the gameplay trailer. But from what I'm getting there, it seems like basically Because Horizon has, like, the time device from Titanfall out of Duardo's collection. And she's going to try to find a way to, you know, obviously, her one big goal was to get back to the past to reunite with her son. And I believe that before I started playing the game, there was, like, a voice line you could find where it's future Horizon in the past saying, well, you did it, you just got to keep trying. But from what I can tell here, it almost looks like Alter might be from the future, and whatever Horizon is doing with this messes up, like, that particular... Time travel is messy. But it's almost like Alter is from a part of the timeline where Horizon's experiments end up destroying, like, her home. Like, Alter's home. And so she's come back in time to try to kill Horizon, probably. You know what? I think that's cool, giving her a connection to the Legends that way. We've already had, you know, characters from the past who've gotten forward, whether in time travel or becoming robots, you know, like Ash or characters like that. And then you have Horizon, who literally came forward in time. Having something coming backwards in time to join the games, I think is an interesting way to approach this. And again, I like her voice, how it sounded like multi-layered. I hope that's what her voice sounds like in-game. I understand it might be a little difficult to understand maybe some of the call-outs, but I like the effect on her voice, and I hope that stays. And also, there was, again, she definitely was making up a lot of the stories here, which makes you wonder what part of it was actually true. So let's go ahead into the breakdown of this trailer and see what we can pick apart to see what is actually probably her actual backstory. Alright, let's go ahead and break this down, because like I said, there's a lot going on here, and a lot of it is definitely her making it up, from what I can... Again, it's either her making it up, or like I said, these are, like, potential, like, alternate versions of her. Because, you know, Wraith always has the whole, all of her different personalities talking. Again, she seems like she's absolutely crazy. And everyone in the games has their own level of quirks and personalities, but I actually kind of like having another crazy, crazy character in the games. Again, I like her design a lot. I think, like, the horns kind of thing she has with her headpiece is cool. She's got, like, shading on the upper part of her face, which really makes her glowing eyes stand out. The hair design is really cool. I like this character design in general. I think this looks really cool. I have to say, with the For Years They Trained Me to Kill Her, the young version of her here looks a lot like, I have to say, looks like young Catalyst for some reason with the hairstyle. Yeah, so I think this story here at the beginning is probably the more accurate one. Yeah, I think that one is probably more accurate to her actual backstory. Again, she's... I also kind of believe the dead parents thing, considering that seems to be an issue with... Like, issues with the parents seems to be all over the Outlands with our characters. Well, that is a cool shot there. I think this has got to be... Lassimosa Armory. That's a nice reference to Titanfall 2 there. Because I actually did play Titanfall 2, so I understand more of these references. Yeah, this right here just... Again, it's hard to tell if they're trying to say that this is an alternate version, like alternate reality, kind of like, we know that there's different dimensions and stuff in this world because Wraith exists. Wraith already has that whole shtick. So it's hard to tell if this is saying that in another life she followed, like, kind of Bloodhound ways, or if this is just her making things up so you don't know what's going on. Because her name is Alter, I'm leaning towards it being, actual alternate realities, that this was basically her life in different worlds. Yeah, that's what I think I'm getting from here. It's a little confusing, but I'm intrigued. I want to know more about this character. That one seems interesting. Kind of wish she continued saying what that one was. This one's just disturbing. That one was just weird. But this part right here. Because again, the in-game teasers we've been getting for the new season have constantly been showing Olympus coming out of a portal, but it also occurred even if you were playing on Olympus. So it's got to be like a future or alternate reality version of Olympus. Like, maybe she's not even from the future. Maybe she's just from an alternate dimension, and Horizon's experiments with the device are causing ripple effects, you know? That'd be believable as well. But she definitely is going after Horizon, which I'm down for more Horizon lore. They got her stories from the Outlands is the one that literally made me cry. Oh, that shot is great. Try to see if I can spot any details here. Wait, hold on. That's the museum from World's Edge in the middle. Is this Capital City? Or, like, the reformed Capital City? Monument? Huh. This might be on World's Edge. Interesting. Because that Olympus was part of the teasers. We know Broken Moon is getting the update for the season. And then that looked a lot like World's Edge. Again, there's a lot of, like I said, there's a lot of pieces to this character. I see like two main possibilities here, that she's either from an alternate universe, and Horizon's experimentation is causing a ripple effect that's affecting her universe, or she's from the future, and she's trying to stop something, like a bad future that Horizon is causing with her experiments. Either way, Horizon's experiments are definitely what leads Alter here. Huh, so Upheaval gameplay trailer on the 3rd. Interesting. Alright, yeah, I want to know more about this character. I don't fully understand what her lore is. I think that's on purpose. She's supposed to be a little bit vague and mysterious, but I want to know more about her. I want to know more of what is going on here. But, you know, this is the first new trailer of the season, which means that they probably have a blog post up, or at least a main website page for Upheaval. We're going to go check that out and see what other details we can find there about the new season. Okay, for some reason it has just a breakout thing at the top, but there's our new character. Okay, finally. So for some reason it just didn't go to the right page at first. But there we go. Apex Legends Upheaval. Watch the new trailer, Alter based on... Oh, so it's just going to say Alter based on true story. So I guess that serves as both a story for the Outlands and launch trailer this season? Interesting. Disturb the Peace. Yeah, that... She definitely would disturb the peace. Like, look how crazy she looks. But again, this is really, like, one of the most... like, visually interesting character designs that they've had in this game in a while. This is really cool. I like her look. Oh, there you go! Standalone and solos is confirmed. Again, I will still try to team up with people for when I do the live stream on launch night, but that's nice to know that solos is a thing that's going to make grinding some of these challenges much easier so you don't have to deal with crazy teammates. New Legend, Alter. A trickster with an unknown past, Alter's here to sow chaos across the Outlands. You know what? We've had a couple of characters most recently that have just been like good intentions and bad situations or something like that. When you have like Vantage, Ballistic, and Conduit, and Catalyst, you know, characters like that. Having a character that is just straight up crazy, I'm down for that. Just having someone who is actually insane and is just here... like, some men just want to watch the world burn. Like, that kind of like a Joker-esque thing. You know, she does have green hair, so that's fitting. I'm down for that. Broken Moon shatters, a lunar nightmare reshapes the battlefield. Yeah. So, Broken Moon is out of rotation right now because it's getting an update. I'm curious what it's actually going to look like. Again, everyone hates Broken Moon. I don't hate Broken Moon. I just like other maps more. Especially because I used to, like, hate Stormpoint. But the recent updates to it have made it really a lot more fun to play, so Broken Moon actually is my least favorite, but I don't hate it like everyone else does. Customizable Apex artifacts, yeah, the universal heirloom crap that everyone's upset about. They really overcharge for that thing. It's, I mean, the idea of a universal heirloom that's customizable, just so that you can have some kind of heirloom in addition to individual legend heirlooms, I think works. But if the rumor is true that they're getting rid of individual legend heirlooms, that I think that this is just going in favor of this, which is all the more expensive collection events. I'm not a fan of that. I really hope that Respawn realizes the reason that the super expensive events with the first universal heirloom did so well is because it was a crossover with Final Fantasy, and not because it was a universal heirloom that people would be willing to pay that much for anything. If it's just a generic dagger like this, people are not going to be willing to pay as much. Yep, there's the new Battle Pass logo for Season 21, Upheaval. Corrupt your form with new items infected by the void. Yeah, again, clearly this character has connections to Wraith as well. So Horizon seems to be like the main story point, but her whole thing has to do with like opening portals and alternate dimensions. I hope we get Wraith interactions with her in the game as well. But okay, this is looks like all we've got for now for Apex Upheaval. Can I look at this real fast? I would like to see the main art for this character. Really, it's just that part of the art? Okay. I was hoping that it would be like a better look at her, but you know, that's a pretty good look. She looks absolutely insane, and I'm excited to see what this is all about. Ooh, look down there. Hold on, real fast. I'm glad I expanded this. Isn't that... Because I know that Broken Moon is the map getting the update, and it's the moon above Seer's homeworld. But isn't this the Arena's map that was set on Seer's homeworld? Like, they added that during the Halloween event that one year. Yeah, I think that's the building from there. So this is not a part of Broken... Unless this is a new POI on Broken Moon, which it easily could be. This looks a lot like the Arena's map. That's interesting. If they're going to bring that map back for whatever reason, or if they're going to bring Arena's map to mixtape for whatever reason. Again, I'd be fine with that. I hated that they pushed Arena so hard with like ranked and stuff like that. That was the main issue I had with it. But like I said, I love the new character design. I'm intrigued by her story, and I want to know more. So, again, I would react to a launch trailer if there was one, but it looks like this is kind of like a Stories from the Outlands and launch trailer rolled into one. So if this is all I end up reacting to for the start of the season, then, whatever. I've got more stuff to react to with Digital Circus coming out this weekend. So there you have it. That was my reaction to Alter based on a true story, the new Apex Legends video. Again, I thought this was just going to be a Stories from the Outlands, and it basically was, but it seems like it's going to serve as the launch trailer for our new season as well, and I want to know more about this character. They were purposefully vague and mysterious and misleading with this, and I always love a good mystery, so I'm looking forward to seeing more of her backstory revealed. I like the idea of after a string of characters that are all good intentioned, I like the idea that even if her motivation has to do with preventing destruction of her home or something like that, the fact that she's just here to be absolutely crazy, I am totally excited for. That's going to be a really fun dynamic to have, kind of offset the recent legends that we have in the game. But again, I'm intrigued by her. I want to know a lot more about this, and I will be live streaming the evening of the day that the new season launches. So Tuesday evening, keep an eye out for when I schedule the stream. I'm looking forward to playing as this character and seeing what's going to happen with her. It's just, she seems really interesting. Like, absolutely insane and a killer and psychotic, but then again, we have characters like that in the game already with Caustic and Revenant and Ash and characters like that, so this isn't anything particularly new to the games, but it is a cool concept that is, we don't fully have the grasp of, but I want to know more. I'm looking forward to see how this story unfolds, you know, as long as they actually put a focus on the story and not just on the cosmetics. But anyway, that was good for this video. Hope you all enjoyed it. Please drop a like and a comment down below if you did, and if you subscribe if you haven't already. And I'll see you all on the next one. Bye, guys!